Paris Filmes apresenta mais uma superprodução. Pousada do Sandy, em Paraty. Os 5 estrelas do litoral norte. Suítes e apartamentos com ar-condicionado. Captain's Bar, pub inglês. Restaurante Che Catalino Internacional. Piscina, sauna seca e a vapor. Sala de jogos. Enfim, tudo o que você necessita para seus fins de semana ou férias 5 estrelas. Passeios de escuna e barco pelas Ilhas Encantadas. Conheça também a cidade histórica de Paraty, com sua arquitetura colonial portuguesa do século XVIII e as autênticas igrejas da Era do Ouro. Pousada do Sandy, Paraty. Largo do Rosário, número 1. Reservas pelos telefones 712100 e 711236.
Are you ready for what is going to be like?
She won't stay, Maggie. I know she won't. I don't want her to come.
Sarah. Sarah Wheaton.
Mr. Wheaton.
Did you bring some sea?
Something from the sea. And me.
Catherine's not coming back. Perhaps it's a mistake to deprive the children of their memories.
That's enough! What do you know about it?
Is it so strange to see a woman behind a plow?
I had a newborn, Sarah. 3-year-old. Farm. Crops, animals, a house.
Sarah had a train to get home, and our bedstand, it's gone! Papa, look! Sarah's brought the sea!
¿Cuándo volveré a verte? Que me mires, hostia. Voy a rezarle al demonio para que se la seque el coño. ¿Tienes algo que decirme?
No. Ya se lo contaré.
Ella lo ocupa todo en mí. Quiero olvidarla y no puedo.
Me tienes loca, cabrón.
No te acerques.
Me voy a acostar.
¿Has estado en la cama con ella?
Lo he soñado. Me cortaré las manos y los pechos. Hasta que no sea más que una ruina a tus pies.
Me voy a romper si no lo hacemos.
¿No has visto cómo te miraba? ¿No has visto que no sabía qué hacer? ¿No has visto que se ha escabullido como una zorra, que es lo que es? Como tú traerás dinero a casa, yo podré cuidarte como a las niñas de mis ojos.
Aunque a mí lo que me gustaría es verla muerta. ¿Por qué no la matas?
Thank you.
Porcelain yet, Pedro Mazaha.
Perfume and spices consigned to one Senora Alaquiz. Yes, I will send your regards to the Senora. Thank you.
Turks.
Since I've taken Constantinople and the Holy Land, they know we only trade on kiosks through their supplies.
The imams and the generals thirst for our blood.
One day they'll have it.
Not today.
Where are you going?
I'm off to the souk to see what I can find.
Well, Cristobal, be careful. Strangers disappear on this island.
How much?
Only 100 dinars. The color, the text, it's fit for a king.
But not even a king could afford it. Can you imagine the profit from a shipload of this?
A shipload, Señor Columbus. It comes across the mountains and deserts from India.
India. I've never seen anything like this.
Nor you won't this side of Cathay. Did you read of Marco Polo? His trip to the Great Khan. Mm-hmm. Cities with roofs of gold. Jeweled trappings for elephants. In the east, my little stall would be a poor thing indeed. Aha! The map. The details of these shorelines came from Turkish sailors. There is no other map so exact.
But surely you have made Chios too large.
It is our island.
What price?
Your Genoese. Ducats. Let's see. 18.
I should have bargained.
Gelsene benimle. Hemen şurada. Hadi gel.
Have your pick. My things. Stick to your profession. Beware the Genoese. And shun the devil.
They may come, my friend, when you smile at fate, and she does not smile back.
Should that day arrive, Rana, I suspect you will be at my side.
Come well prepared, Cristobal Colón.
Monsignor Camus. This is my son, Diego. Oh, 2 months ago I lost my wife, Donna Filipa.
I'm sorry. I will pray for her soul.
Thank you, Monsignor. What I have to show you has cost me 6 years and most of what I own.
If your maps are as convincing as your letters, I will not only present your idea to King John, I will support it.
For 5 years, I have lived and sailed out of Porto Santo to Iceland, the Canaries, down the coast of Africa to Lamina.
Señor Colón, this is our sea. Portuguese captains explored these waters and have sailed them more often than you.
But always near to land, Your Grace. In the Azores, Colón found a log carved with tools. It had floated ashore from the west.
Your Highness, here's Cathay, the great celestial cities of Quince and Titan.
Then 500 leagues into the sea, Cipango, and many other islands. But all set in one great sea. Marco Polo called it an ocean sea. Your sea,
polar sea. The Earth is a sphere, as Aristotle, Ptolemy, and all cosmographers tell us. And it is my belief your sea ends in polos. They are, in fact, the same sea.
And the best way to reach the Indies is not through the Turks of Constantinople. It is not around the coast of Africa, as your highness seeks, but it is by sailing west across the one ocean sea.
It's a very ambitious plan, Senor Colón.
I have further proofs and many details for the working of the voyage, your highness.
Good. Very good. If we were to take the risk of supplying the required ships, what fee would you expect?
I am to be named governor under your highness of all lands discovered. I and my heirs are to have 1/10 of all revenue from Portuguese trade with the Indies.
No Portuguese captain ever received a fraction of that.
No Portuguese captain has yet taken your ships to the Indies.
Perhaps your highness would care to consider it in council?
Yes. You're a very unusual man, Senor Colón. And it would honor me if you remain at home, as it were, in my realm.
It would be my humble pleasure, Your Highness, to accommodate Senor Colón at my estate.
Good suggestion, Lord Guaco. It is settled then, until the council considers. We keep the maps to further consider.
Spain's not far.
There we'll be safe.
Friend, you fear it will be a Portuguese who will be the first.
It's possible, but it will not be an easy voyage. Now I'm going to France. I've written to the French king.
But have you not tried our queen?
No.
Or King Ferdinand?
How would I ever get an audience? Their minds and their money are engaged with the crusade against the Moors.
Before Father Torquemada became the queen's confessor, our prior held that office. He can get you an audience. And the Duke de Medina Celi, a man also in love with cosmography, he might be convinced to put up part of the money. If I could assure them that I myself believed your enormous ocean sea could truly be sailed, to go and return.
There is one secret I've told no one. I will speak it to you, but only in the confessional, where you have sworn before our Lord never to reveal it.
If it should be true.
The wealth may well be beyond imagining, but the cost will be considerable. What exactly is your background, Senor Colón?
I have served many noble monarchs, Your Highness. The Prince of Anjou, The King of Portugal.
Portugal. Why did he not send you?
King John is still seeking a route to the Indies around Africa, Your Highness. If indeed Africa has an end.
Yes.
And if he finds it, then Portugal will be the greatest kingdom of all Europe.
For 700 years, the Moors have held power in Spain. It has always been my dream. Should God give me the crown of Castilla, I might one day recapture all of those domains for Christendom with the good right arm of the church. And my husband's bravery on the battlefield, God may yet grant me that dream. But
how much more you've dreamed, Señor Colón. Take the word of the gospel to all of the Indies, to Cathay, to India, to the unknown Cipango, to do as our Lord bid his apostles to do, go into all of the world and preach my word. We must have our best scholars and priests examined.
In Genoa, of what rank was your father?
My father was descended from the senator Galeotto de Mari, who founded the Bank of the Genoa.
If it would be. If it would be. I thank you for coming, Signor Colón.
Sail with you again?
By every saint in the Christian calendar, Cristobal, I would sail with you to hell.
Diego de Arana, here's to you. I might even bring him back if fate smiles on us.
Oh!
Captain Beatrice!
My maps!
Which one of you is Cristobal Colón?
I am.
Come with us.
No, no. There's nothing to fear, I'm sure.
Señor Colón.
Nostrum salute, ecetit in
cielo, et in est Spiritus Sancto, Maria Regina, et omnes patris, crucifix, et
your name. Does the Queen know I'm being questioned?
Until a case is brought before the tribunal of the Holy Office, all questioning is as secretive as the confessional. Your name?
Cristobal Colón.
Do you take the sacraments?
I do.
Do you know why you were arrested?
It is beyond my imagination.
The function of the Inquisition is to redeem the souls of fallen Christians.
I am not a fallen Christian.
Well, heresy by its nature is insidious. It infects many who presume that they are innocent. But for the soul who has gone away from God, even perhaps without knowing, the way back is full of pain. And the first step is confession.
Torture. Torture may lead one to confess something that is not true.
Well, to be a true believer and unjustly condemned to death, that is the way to glory. To die for the faith in the faith, that soul will certainly see the gates of paradise.
It is a goal I seek. But Perhaps not that way. May I know why you doubt my faith?
I have been to my manuscripts. The blessed St. Augustine has said that the ocean sea cannot be crossed. And in your ambition, Signor Colon, you are presuming to defy the judgment of the Holy Father of the Church.
Not on a matter of the faith, Your Grace. The blessed saint also wrote that no man could exist beyond the torrid zone of Africa because those men would not descend from Adam. Yet the Portuguese and I have found men and life where he said none could exist. I defer to the Holy Father's knowledge of men's hearts. His science was imperfect.
Well, you appear well read, Signor Colon.
Only in cosmography, Your Grace, and the Bible. I recall our blessed Lord said, a new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another as I have loved you. Surely, it is not blasphemy to take that message to the shores of Africa or across the ocean sea.
I will never share the noble standing of Diego's mother. You will never marry me. Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Oh! And if you succeed on your voyage, you will retire me to some distant estate where I may hear of you now and then. But perhaps you'll never return. And I shall be empty inside forever.
It may be that I cannot marry you, but I do love you. And you'll always be at my side.
Cristobal! Cristobal! You must go! Why?
The commission have announced they've reached the final stages of their deliberations.
No.
Cristobal! I haven't told you my news!
I must go. I have to be there.
Going to have your child.
The Queen has left to lay siege to Malaga. Father Torquemada convened the commission in her absence. It is the commission's opinion that your arguments do not outweigh the conclusions of the great doctors of the church that say the ocean sea may not be crossed.
But, Your Grace...
The decision is final.
I thank Your Graces.
A third of your population will be sent to Maroc in exchange for the Christian slaves held there. One third we will sell to reimburse our treasury, and one third will be given in slavery to Rome and Naples for their support of the Crusades.
Your Highnesses, Señor Colón.
When I heard of your victory, Your Highnesses, I was moved to thoughts of the glory of Spain.
Which, of course, prompted you to thoughts of your dubious quest.
Of course, Your Highness.
Father Torquemada and I have discussed the new evidences you have found from the Old Testament, that our world is largely land, and therefore the ocean sea cannot be as great as our scholars presume.
These are from the Apocrypha. Doubtful sources, but not to be ignored. We might reconvene the commission.
I have received an envoy from Portugal, one I have reason to call a friend. He tells me the king sent a strong ship from the Azores on a voyage of discovery, such as you recommended to him. This most experienced captain sailed for weeks and found nothing save immeasurable rough sea. He returned to Lisbon, thanking God for preserving his life and laughing at the idea that by such a course the Indies could be found.
Fortunately for Spain, Your Highness, I did not tell the Portuguese king all.
Ah, yes. This is the famous secret.
Yes, my lord.
And it is still not something you care to share with us.
I still cannot, Your Highness.
I defer you to my queen, Your Highness.
Pray clear the court.
Clear the court!
Father, would you leave us, please? Our commission may have been overzealous. I want you to know that you and your dream have often been in my prayers these 2 years.
Then some of my prayers have been answered, Your Highness.
We are hard pressed for treasure. The Moors still hold the fortress of Granada and await reinforcements from Morocco. But I would like to grant you a small allowance. You might continue in your preparations.
I am grateful to Your Highness.
Diego, why don't you lend your father a hand?
I'll watch him do it.
Don't you ever want to learn to sail?
Down.
I'll take care of it.
I was hoping to take you as an apprentice when I sail.
I'll be too old by the time you get a ship, Father.
Let me tell you something.
Christopher!
Lord, why have you forsaken me?
Because it's spring, you get southeasterly, so I've marked the shoals in red. Stay well off as you approach, or you get driven onto them.
I'm not much of an artist, but you are a seaman, Cologne.
If you ever come to your senses about the Indies, I'll make a place for you on one of my ships.
My brother's at the English court right now. I'm not giving up.
Maybe I'll just get Isaac to dismiss you.
I cannot dismiss him. He owes me too much money.
Well, then, perhaps this will help. Thank you.
Fra Juan has some news about the Inquisition.
About me?
No, but I fear it may touch you.
Why would it affect me?
Because you work for a Jew.
This message has been distributed to be read at all masses this fourth Sunday of Advent. It is ordered that all Jews will be expelled from Spain unless they can accept baptism and conversion to the Holy Faith. Our edicts stress that they would prefer us to make converts. They want you to stay.
What they want is to confiscate their wealth to appease the population.
But all those who continue the old practices in secret will be labeled heretics and could be put to death at the stake. They and all those who help them.
This is my home. It's all I have. I must stay.
No, I cannot do it. You will have to sell everything, and you will get nothing for it.
I still cannot do it.
How about you, Benjamin?
Wait, Colonel!
I bring news from the Queen!
The Moors have surrendered. Spain is Christian. You're the first to benefit.
Go. Like Fra Juan Perez, I've always believed you were a child of God. I'm glad for you.
Go.
Allah Akbar. God is great.
Yes. He's given Spain to his son in answer to the prayers of a young girl. God is great, and our debt to him is infinite.
Señor Colón, you look splendid.
I am honored Her Highness would think of me in her moment of triumph.
In my debt to God, I intend to carry his word to the Indies. If I must pawn my own crown jewels to do so.
As master of this enterprise, what rewards do you expect, Señor Colón? I am to be titled Admiral of the Ocean Sea and Viceroy of all islands and continents discovered or conquered through my efforts. These offices and the title Don Cristobal Colón shall pass to my heirs and successors forever. In addition,
there is more.
A tenth of all goods acquired from these dominions will belong to me, free of taxation.
Until now, I questioned your mathematics, Señor Colón, but I see that was a mistake.
I will give half of my share to support, with your highnesses, a crusade to free the Holy Land of the Turks.
How generous of you. Modify your requests. We all know your condition.
Your Highness, if I fail, I get nothing. If France or Genoa or Venice takes my offer and I succeed, their kingdoms will know wealth and power beyond.
Go to France. Go to Genoa. But don't utter threats in my presence again.
Cristobal, modify your request.
Your Highness, I cannot.
With women, Cologne.
I'm from Genoa, Your Ladyship.
I believe you will find the Indies. And as God has given me my dream, I intend to give you yours.
I know it will be a strength to me in the many times I will need strength.
I, too, have had only my pride and my faith in God to light my way. God go with you, Don Cristobal Colón.
Colón, it's the greatest ship in the world.
Call me Captain General.
What do you think, Señor de la Cosa? Will you go on this insane voyage?
The Queen may have ordered me to lease my ship to Cologne. But not even she can force me to sail with it.
Oh, Pinzon! I have three ships! I have no crew! I could use your influence! Sail with me! Into uncharted seas with a Genoese mapmaker who's not sailed for 6 years? Keep dreaming, Cologne!
She's a fine vessel. Perhaps a bit top heavy and too narrow of beam. Not unlike someone else I know.
Could talk a queen into parting with her jewelry. I'll make you remember me, Christopher.
Maravedis. 20,000 maravedis to the man who can make an egg stand upright.
As if we had nothing better to do, huh?
It's impossible, right? Waste of...
Let Cologne try himself.
Yeah, let's see him do it.
Told us we could crack the egg.
I never said the eggshell couldn't be cracked.
No one thought of it, or dared to try.
He's trying to make fools of us.
It is ignorance and lack of courage which makes fools of men. Listen to me. I tell you that a well-disciplined ship can make this voyage.
Cheap little trick.
Huh? It proves nothing about the Sea of Darkness.
A sea so broad, even if Cathay were on the other side, no man would live to see it.
He knows what he's saying, Cologne. Listen to him.
Let the man speak!
The world is round, correct? Where I stand, it will be the beginning and the end. 0 degrees and 360 degrees. Where Martin stands, 90 degrees. De La Cosa, half the globe, 180 degrees. Vicente, 3/4 of the globe, 270 degrees. Can you follow that?
Don't insult me, Cristobal.
The length of Europe and Asia to the tip of Cathay is roughly 260 degrees. So this is Cathay. Remember, Marco Polo made this trip, and he made measurements every month. Beyond Cathay is Cipango, let's say 28 to 30 degrees.
Polo never saw Cipango.
No, but he had the word of Chinese sea captains.
So we can't be sure.
The ocean sea is 70 degrees of the world. There are 45 miles to a degree, so it is 3,000 miles from Palos to Cipango, and 2,400 miles from the Canaries. A well-provided, a well-disciplined ship can make that.
What if your figures are wrong?
They are not wrong.
Would you sail with him, Frau Wan?
Alas,
it is not possible. But if it were?
There is no power on this earth saving the Holy Father would keep me from making this voyage of discovery.
Wait. What about you, Vicente?
I think I shall tell my grandchildren that I sailed the ocean sea.
Why should a sailor loaf about in Palos
when he can find houses of gold and scarves of silk
for his lady?
We need a good carpenter.
Make your sign, draw half your wages. Your family will eat like royalty while you're dancing with the Chinese ladies.
Dancing with the devil is what I fear, Captain. But with you, I may curse my luck that I never went. I'm with you, sir.
I want to see the Celestial City.
The talk of Marco Polo has turned your head, Bartholomew.
The Lord God will give me courage. It is his will that I should make this journey.
You will piss your pants the first time we lose sight of land.
How short will we be?
Perhaps 20.
I'd rather take a willing coward than an unwilling criminal. We'll have to take enough of those as it is.
All right, Vives. Sign your life away.
Gonzalo. Seaman.
This is a waste of time.
Well, we have no choice, Havana. 8 men have deserted already.
There's not a man here who would survive the voyage.
If a man can survive here, he can survive anywhere. You know my mission. The Queen has offered pardon to all who sail with me. I want volunteers. What is your crime?
Murder.
So modest, Roldan. Rape and murder.
I am fit, strong, and able. If it will buy me my freedom, I will sail to the end of the earth with you, Colon.
That's exactly what he may be doing.
What about you?
I'd rather live like a rat than drown like one.
We could use a tailor. We'll be trading for silks and fine linens and gold thread.
It's another gift from the Queen to the Captain General.
Rodrigo de Escobedo, at your service.
The secretary to record our discoveries.
Rodrigo Sanchez.
From the treasury. Test the gold we trade for.
Luis de Torres.
Renowned interpreter. Speaks all the languages of the known world. We could use you.
Alvaro de Arana. Volunteer from the court of the Duke of Medina Celi. Father.
Bring your effects aboard.
You said 10,000 maravitas.
5 now, 5 after the voyage. Provided Colón fails, or better yet, never returns. Portugal does not want Spain to succeed in this voyage.
What if you never return, Gonzalo? How does a pardoned convict get the rest of his money from the court of Portugal?
They'll know who you are.
My father said that you would guarantee my life when we return.
Benjamin, I swear on my eternal soul that before they take your life, they will have to take mine too.
Even if I do not take the faith?
I know where your heart is. Stay at the back of the crew at prayers. Only I will see you.
Hora!
God go with you, Christopher.
I'm depending on it. Diego, look after your brother while I'm away. Come here. Goodbye. And I love you. Nothing? What is it between Harana and his son?
He seduced my sister when she was 14. When she was with child, Alvaro repudiated her, calling her a whore. She drowned herself.
Your families have lived here for more than 3 centuries. The church, the queen, begged you to remain. And all that is asked is that you join with us, one nation, one faith. Then may your voyage have the favor of God's blessing. And yours too. Queen, my victory may be obscured by this Genoese foreigner. As God is just, I suspect that he will never return. Believe me, Spain will still be true to one faith when his little voyage is long forgotten.
Sail south, Captain General. Into the heat?
We'll take on fresh water and provisions in the Canaries. Have you ever sailed into the ocean sea, Alvar?
No, sir. I'm only an adventurer. The sailor is my father.
Alvaro, I am master of arms aboard this ship. Refer to me as anything else, and I'll put you in chains.
Now, you know why I volunteer for this voyage. I wish to redeem myself with my father.
You have quite a task ahead of you.
Be grateful you have a father.
I, Gonzalo, cannot say the same.
I swear before God only one of us will live to return to Spain.
Discipline, and discipline we will have. Señor de la Cosa,
Set the topsail. Tighten the sheets and tacks. We've lost enough time already.
Set the topsail. Tighten the sheets and tacks.
The corporal who becomes Captain General. He will learn the loyalty of men cannot be taken. It must be won.
Bring the coil of it, Jim.
Needed a good wash.
Not many have sailed this far into the ocean sea.
I was twice your age before I sailed one night west from the Canaries. And at dawn I had to turn back, or the crew would have mutinied.
What is out there?
Find a place to sleep. The day begins early tomorrow.
Yes, Captain General.
Five is passed and six flows. More shall flow if God wills.
Gave Pinson the order to let that man down.
Hide it! Get up!
This is our man. I found him in the hall, using this to cut a hole, just like in the Pinta. The Portuguese. Are you alone, or are there others? After a day or two of sun, he'll be telling us all he knows. Master at arms, show the men how we deal with traitors. Pedro?
Captain! Watch out!
Ship to the mast! Morelos, get below, report the damage. The rest of you, back to work!
Him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call upon me and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him with long.
Might be the mast of an Indian ship or a Chinese junk.
Aye, or a piece of Noah's Ark.
Ship
beneath that broken mast we saw. What do you think happened to them?
Morales!
A Phoenician once told me they saw a sea demon off the Azores, big enough to swallow a ship whole.
All my life I've been chasing the sun, and at last I feel I'm going to catch it.
How many miles are we making?
You must be doing several, all right.
But that is our secret.
In my log, I'm recording less. Every hour further from Spain, more and more the crew begin to wish they'd never heard the name Colón.
Let's take him down.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die.
See the land in the west.
You will live, Morales. You will live. You may even live to be rich. Listen.
Listen to me, all of you. The first man among you to sight land will earn himself a life pension of 10,000 maravedis a year from the king.
10,000 maravedis.
Maravedis.
Ferdinand will be amazed by his own generosity.
Look at them, Aaron. How the promise of gold makes them put aside their fears.
At least for the present.
What is it? What does he see?
He
He has the look of a man possessed.
Set course due west. Square the yard. And sail her pulling by.
Right the yard arm. Go square now.
How does Joe wish know?
It is his gift. Get back to your station.
It's not just about how far we've come, Cristobal. This bitch of a wind is always out of the east.
It'll take months to beat our way back.
Tomorrow we may find headwinds again and you still won't be content. Hey, I've never heard man frown so much at good fortune. Listen.
Don't you want to go back? You still think he's going to find anything but his maker out there?
Torres, he'll take us all to hell. That's what he'll do.
I have to ask the next watch.
What happened?
Nothing, Captain. I fell.
It was Roldan, wasn't it?
After all, he'll be everyone's hero when he gets back to Spain.
If he gets back. Many of us do.
Captain! Captain!
Quiet!
It's a cloud! Just a cloud. It's breaking up!
There's nothing out there. We sail to nothing but our death.
We will die for the greed of a Genoese.
Get back to your work, Morales. See him like this, they'll lose faith.
You said my faith would light my way, yet all I see before me is a sea of darkness. Why, Your Highness, why has God forsaken me? Why?
The ship. They're coming for you.
Then I shall greet them.
I hold the Queen's commission. Mutiny. Mutiny is punishable by death. If I cannot execute this sentence here, I can assure you that it will be done in Spain.
You also have a commission from God to protect the lives of your crew.
Captain, I will not sacrifice myself for a madman's vanity.
I beseech you, come on. Turn back, and you may remain Captain General.
You have no other choice.
You have given me much to think about. But first, I must talk to my captains. Master at arms. Ask the Pinzons to join us tonight in my cabin.
You heard what he said. Get back to your duties.
To the commencement of our return to Spain.
Gentlemen, for the past 32 days, I've kept you informed of our progress. I told you we have sailed over 1,754 miles west of the Canary. I lied. I lied in order not to scare our men. But in fact, we have traveled over 2,379 miles. What say you now, good captains?
We may reach hell before we reach the Indies.
We must turn back or suffer the consequences.
A reward from the king will no longer suffice, Colon. The men talk of throwing you to the sharks if you don't listen to reason.
3 days. Tell the men we sail west for 3 more days. If we don't sight land on the morning of the 4th day, you must give the order to turn the ships around.
On that morning, if we don't sight land, I will give the order for my head to roll on the deck. I make this oath in the name of our Lord. That is how you will appease your men.
Isabella will have our heads.
It is your sworn duty to obey you, Captain General. The order will be written by my own hand. And I will entrust it to you, Pinzon.
don't take it.
Bags! 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 Bags!
I think we must be near land.
Birds that live on the sea, perhaps. Who knows what strange things this ocean holds?
It's a sign. Surely. It's a sign.
This is a sure sign of land.
No birds today?
No.
Have we sailed past the landfall?
According to the maps your father and I made, well past it.
Could you be wrong?
I may have calculated the degrees too short, but Cathay must be close.
Took a sounding, 200 fathoms. We didn't touch bottom.
God give us a good night. Count and fast and make voyage fast.
The Pinta! Oh, the watch! Do you see it?
See what? Yes, yes, the light!
It looks like somebody's signaling with a lantern. La Nina! Do you see it?
No. Which direction?
Off the port bow!
There! I cannot see it!
Gone! But it was there. It was there. Devil be this. St. Elmo's fire. St. Elmo's the patron saint of sailors. Has anyone seen Benjamin? You can't miss this.
Hello, boy.
No!
I'm gonna show you something.
Wait!
Was watching over you tonight. You must be a true sailor.
Cristobal.
Do not look so grim, my friend. It was always my wish to die at sea.
For our friend Pinzon.
Be quick about this.
Oh Lord, we understand. With you, there is forgiveness. Therefore, you are
forgiven. You own the ship, Villacosa.
I cannot.
No.
I'll do it.
You therefore you are feared. I wait. My soul waits. And in his word I put my hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than watcher wait for the morning. More than watcher wait for the morning.
Thank God. Thank Saint Elmo. Thank all the angels and saints. Oh, God and Spain.
So where do you think we are, Captain General?
We have landed in the Indies, my friend. My title is now Admiral of the Ocean Sea. This must be one of the islands of Cipango.
Bring the men ashore. Let their feet touch the ground.
Aye, Captain. Admiral.
Ricardo!
Captain!
Bring the men to land!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Master at arms! Turn, cavalry! Wait!
They don't look like Chinamen, Cristobal.
Marco Polo said there were over 7,000 islands off Cathay. This must be one of the outer Indies.
I hope so.
I think we're gods.
As in Africa, in all new lands, gods have a duty. Since no one has come forward to oppose us, I hereby claim this land in the name of our glorious king and queen, Ferdinand and Isabella of Spain.
Hooray! Hooray! Hooray!
And in honor of our savior who has led us to it, I name it San Salvador.
Amen. Amen.
Them, we want to meet their mayor and ask them if they are subjects of the great Khan.
Tell me, n'avez-vous mis ton vassal SS? Il pas coûté son mega Khan? Woman, Hansi Wan, Nita Daran.
Mm.
Noridu un Nalkati bisiema com. Com. Provocatore de noi alla hinumele cavolo. Wir wollen seine Führer betreffen.
For God's sake, the Thoris.
They don't speak any language.
Of course they speak a language.
Well, it's not a civilized language.
If the Portuguese can talk with the Africans, the Spanish will talk with the Indians. Yes. Now, the Thoris, you start learning their language.
Admiral!
Look at his nose.
What? It's an ornament.
Sanchez?
Yes, Admiral.
Come on, come on. Stop picking at him! You're frightened. It's gold.
Yes, Admiral.
Your brother deserted last night.
Sanchez said there are rivers of gold on the other islands. Martin must have gone there. Or perhaps your brother has sailed for Spain to claim my glory and my rewards.
No, Admiral, no. Such a thing he would never do.
Oh, no.
The chief's daughter, Admiral, from the neighboring island.
Tell her I gladly accept her offering.
Udo.
And that in return, I give her what my queen gave me. This represents the enlightenment that our faith has to offer to your people.
Nichichi. Udo.
Tell her that now we will sail to her island. But I would like her and her father to be my guests for dinner. Explain that tomorrow is the birthday of our Savior, and that tonight we celebrate in joy. Prepare the ships for departure!
Chichi. Obutu? Obutu?
Aurora. Hiki.
Hiki.
Siki.
Sa. Sa Karim.
Siki.
Atores.
It's very good.
Feliz Navidad.
Feliz Navidad.
Wine.
Nichichi. Nichichi from us to you.
Nichichi.
Oh!
Pick up.
It's very sharp. You have... Spanish blade.
The safety of the Santa Maria was your responsibility, Colon. It is you I blame.
And it is I you obey, Della Cosa. Help salvage what we can.
God help you. When you tell the men why so many of them must remain behind.
It was God's divine will that the Santa Maria go aground here. Providence has chosen this site for the first permanent Christian settlement. I name it Navidad because it was begun on the day of our Lord's birth. These Indians are a kind and generous people, and I believe they can all be converted to our Queen's holy faith. Treat them kindly, and they will help us build and explore and lead us to the mountains of gold. I leave Diego de Arana in charge here until my return in the spring. May we ask God's blessing for all that you do here. May his spirit bless and protect you.
Amen. The Pinta!
Spain not only needs new souls, Cristobal. She needs gold. While you were spreading the word of God...
You took the Pinta inland without my permission.
I ask my Admiral's forgiveness.
For defying me or for bringing back so little?
It's all there was to be found.
Then, Captain Fitzhorn, tell your men to turn over every ounce of gold in their possession to the master at arms.
What happened to the houses of gold and scarves of silk?
See that your crew is prepared. Our caravels depart for Spain day after tomorrow. Don't just sit there. Go to work.
Now we shall see. Who wins favor?
That's mine.
I took no gold, sir.
Orders have been obeyed.
Admiral.
You have your gold.
It is Spain's gold, my friend. The Torquemada and our queen will be expecting new Christian souls. I want 6 heathens that I can convert and bring before the royal court.
You've taken their gold, Cristobal. Isn't that enough?
Choose the 6 finest men on this island, Rana, and see that they are aboard the Niño when I leave.
You join me. Come. Carosuna!
Lost him in that last squall. Shall I ease the sheets until we can see some sign of him?
The Admiral knows his winds. He has no need of us. On this voyage, the Pinta waits for no one.
No!
Go fish, Morales. I'll give it back to you when I'm done.
You have plenty, Alvaro. This one is mine. Leave her! I mean it. Think!
Morales?
Think!
Is one of them worth dying for? There are hundreds just like her. Now they know we're not gods.
I always knew you weren't a guy.
You're a murderer. You're a rapist. You're a thief. You're under arrest.
I promise you a burial at sea, Father.
Killing. Get up.
jealousy. Now!
The head man still refuses.
I promise to deliver the word of God. Shackley. Shackley. The Torres, tell them. The heathens who do not become new Christians shall be slaves. Spain has need of both.
Stop him!
Did the Admiral have any further orders?
Terreros, shackle all of them. The Torres, carry on. Carry on! Salve Regina! Mater misericordiae! Sing with me, sing for your own sake, sing with me. Salve Regina! Salve Regina! Sing! Salve Regina! Mater misericordiae! Vita dulcedo. Good, good, again. Salve Regina.
Your Highnesses, I bring you news of a new world. With riches beyond your wildest. Oh. I, Martin Alonso Pizol.
What have you got there? A gift? Bring it. Bring it. Bring it here.
My father's belongings.
He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul.
What? What? What are you looking at?
What do you want from me?
Righteousness!
What do you want from me?
What do you want from me?
If you, O Lord, can rescue...
Golong is a fool. To think heathens like you could ever be souls of the church. Look at you! Look at you! You're nothing but savages. Oh. How many more do I have to kill? How many?
Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Oh.
God meant for me to make this voyage, as he means for us to weather this storm and return to Spain in triumph. Benjamin!
Admiral!
Get over the boy!
Admiral!
Herreros, unshackle the Indian!
Aye, Admiral.
In this battle, address to Queen Isabella, is recorded every detail of my glorious discovery. I, Don Cristobal Colón, Viceroy of the Indies!
The loss of my ship, compared to the wealth of discovery that you bring back for the glory of Spain.
Since you must get well, and together we will go to the royal court.
I've watched you, mapmaker. You rigged us to sail only with the wind. In the heat of August, we sailed south. The wind came from the east. In winter, when we returned, we sailed north with wind from the west. Yeah, the secret rivers of wind.
Yes, there are rivers of wind blowing in both directions.
That was your glorious secret.
That the wind would last across the whole of the ocean sea, I did not know. But you and I, Martin, proved it. We have accomplished the most wonderful navigation.
Christopher. Don't let greed put you in chains. Go. Claim your glory. God be with you.
God be with you. And God bless you.
Thank you.
Had I known he would succeed, to bestow such honor and wealth on the Genoese.
Ah, what a glorious day for Spain. Rise, Don Cristobal Colon. It is for us to salute you on this day of God's blessing.
Your Highnesses, Your Grace, you will rejoice in the knowledge I have delivered Christ's blessings across the ocean sea. Your Highness, from your new realm in the Indies, I bring you new Christian souls. And for you, Your Highness, I bring a bounty such as Spain has never seen.
You have now proclaimed yourself an apostle.
To quote the scriptures, he made me the messenger and showed me the way.
Then it is he who will judge you for what you have done.
Bow down before me. I, Ferdinand of Aragon, declare that from this day forward you shall be known as Admiral of the Ocean Sea and Viceroy of the Indies. You may rise. Admiral Colon, you have earned our respect and admiration. Now, where is my gold?
Show me Cristobal. Show me the new world.
Your new world. There you are.